Hi teachers, my name is Gabriel Reyes-Rodriguez. I'm a fourth year graduate student in the chemistry and biochemistry program at UCSD. I work with Charles Perry doing organic chemistry research, and the project I'm going to be talking about is bringing some organic chemistry research into the classroom. I was able to develop this project with the help of Colleen Robinson at Helix Charter High School chemistry students in 10th, 11th, and 12th grade. So I decided to call my project Save Our Chemist, separating a mixture of aspirin and acetaminophen using extraction techniques. And the main objectives of my projects are to define concepts such as solubility, polarity, attraction forces, organic, aqueous, layer, acid-base reactions, and extractions. I want also the students to know and understand how to separate a mixture of organic compounds using methods of extraction. Students will know the importance of solubility, acid-base reactions, and pH in the process of extractions, and they will know and feel comfortable with the different techniques involved in extraction processes. So this is a really cool experiment for you teachers to perform in your classroom, because it's an opportunity for you to bring some of the organic chemistry research we do in graduate school to high school students and bring them the opportunity of developing those skills and learning and understanding the different processes involved in organic chemistry research. So my experiment, I started with a block separation experiment where the students are able to separate blocks, Lego blocks, depending on some features that they observe, probably color, shape, or sizes, and I want them to transfer from one bag to the other. It allows students to understand the separation from one face to the other, from one side to the other, just by playing with Lego blocks. Then I introduce the definition of extraction, a colloquial definition, and I give examples of colloquial extractions, and then I'm able to define what is an extraction in chemistry. I also talk and give different examples of extractions in chemistry in the research, in our daily lives, and then I start explaining how is it that extraction works. I talk about solubility, I talk about attraction forces, electronegativity, polarity, like dissolves like, and I introduce this concept with a really, really cool activity where they get to chew gum and eat chocolate at the same time. So when we're chewing gum, basically we're extracting sugar and other flavorings from the gum to the saliva, right? So the saliva, mainly composed of water, then is able to make soluble the sugar and other flavorings because they share the same attraction forces. Now, the gum never dissolves. And why is that? Well, saliva doesn't share the same attraction forces as the gum. But as soon as you add chocolate, then the students presence in their mouth the chemistry, because the cocoa butter, which is mainly composed of fat, shares the same attraction forces as the gum and is able to dissolve this. After that, in my lecture, I keep explaining how is it that extraction works, moving compounds from one phase to the other, organic solvents, aqueous solvents. So finally, I engage students with an electronic tour through the UCSD chemistry labs and facilities in order to introduce this lab of saving a chemist by separating two analgesics. So the students are in the chemistry building, just presencing chemists performing different lab techniques in the lab, but suddenly an earthquake occurs, and then the students are okay, but the chemist gets hurt. He's allergic to one of the analgesics, which is the acetaminophen, but the first aid kit gets destroyed during the earthquake. So the pills get all mixed up and the chemist is in a lot of pain, so they have to perform an extraction to be able to separate aspirin from acetaminophen, provide aspirin to the chemist because the acetaminophen could kill, right? So why do teachers should do this lab, right? And so this lab is designed to introduce students to the technique of extractions. It's a guided based approach, we only present enough background to enable students to understand the principles involving in extraction and the different techniques involved performing extraction in our chemistry labs. So the students are going to be exposed to real world applications, collaborative work, exploration, discovery, and they're going to be able to connect details and come up with explanations. What is the classroom going to look like when you're doing this lab? Well, the classroom is not going to look like. The classroom is going to become a chemistry, an organic chemistry research laboratory, right? Because the students are going to be using glassware, they're going to be measuring liquids, they're going to be filtrating stuff, they're going to be doing chemicals tests and observe changes in color. They're going to have a lot of fun checking the separatory funnel and evidencing the formation of gases by releasing air pressure from the funnel. They're going to also be evaporating organic solvents, and they're going to observe the formation of crystals at the end of their lab, and they're also going to have the opportunity of test for the purity of their compounds. So this is a really cool, like a super cool and unique activity, right? First of all, because it's made here at UCSD, it's made by me, a graduate student, and a collaborative work with the high school teacher in chemistry. And also, this is not something that I'm just making up for you to do, so this is something that has been tested at different schools, that we've proven that it works, and the feedback tells everything. So the students are all crazy about it. They really like the saving the chemist activity. They really enjoy the separation, especially the part where they have to perform the extraction and do the changing of the different liquids. And of course, the important thing is bringing the research into the classroom, starting to introduce such a hard concept as organic chemistry to high school kids. It gives us the opportunity of opening the doors for chemical research to high school students.